Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. This is so cool. We're here in New York City for the World Modeling Competition. I have Mack Wilk, who's here all the way from Poland. This is called Unlimited Number of Credits. All right, Mack. So, Mack, how long have you been using Excel?
6 years at PwC and more than 10 years in total.
That's cool. Where'd you hear about the competition?
Oh, what, from one of my clients?
Oh, really?
Told me to take part in this competition.
So, two rounds, started out with 2,000 people, and you're down to one of the final 16. You got to fly to New York City. So, what's your trick today?
Okay, my trick is to add some basic elasticity to the model. We will do that on the examples of loans and credits, and we built a template which will enable you to add unlimited number of loans and credits. And you can do the same with provisions, with costs, with certain contracts, with to model revenues. It have very broad functionality. Okay, so let's see on the screen. As you can see here,
Now they can see down to row 14. So scroll down for us.
Okay.
Okay. So you build a nice little template.
Yeah. Here's the template of the credit. You have the name of the credit. We can change it to anything we want. Here you have some basic modeling of the balance sheet positions, opening balance, increases, decreases of the credit balance, loans and credits, closing balance. Here is the calculation of interest. Now we can go up to the summary section, and right here we put SUMIF formula. So here it is.
Okay, your pay special there was pay special formulas, right?
Yeah.
You did all
ESF, yeah.
ESF, all right.
Okay. We can also group the rows right here too.
Change. Now scroll down so we can see that.
Yeah.
All right, so you selected from which row to which row?
We selected from the beginning of the first credit down to line end of credits,
okay,
which finish the area, the calculation area when we can add the credits. I also grouped the rows in order to make it look more simple. We can also use the option to change the outline settings right here. It will make whole thing even more readable. And right now, the main feature. Right now, we can add as many credits as we want.
Oh, you're always adding them above the end of credits bar.
Exactly, and you can see on the summary section that it changes all the time. And if I delete three of them, or if I delete first two, it will change automatically. And that's how my model has all this elasticity. My clients can add 1, 2, 3, 5, 10, or even more credits. They can do the same with certain costs, with certain revenue lines. It can be used in many, many areas in the model.
Okay, this is great. Now, that how will happen so fast. Say that you want to add another credit. I want to see slowly how you add a credit. So you're going from row 11?
I just grab all the lines of the template, or more easy, I can group the rows and just.
So you went from 11 to 24. So you're including everything that's grouped plus the row below it.
Yes,
that's
exactly
the only way to get everything. Okay,
got exactly.
It. And then Control C.
Yeah, I copy and insert copied cells.
Copy cells. Inserts that whole block, which is all now nicely formatted, exactly like the original one.
Yep.
They can just add. It looks like you're adding a row, but you're really adding a whole section. There, that's a great trick. All right,
exactly. Cool. And of course I can model more about the credit. I can add different currencies, different FX differences,
It can be as complicated as you want.
Sky is the limit, yeah.
But again, with that grouping, then you can just add more and more and more, and it always adds up at the top. What a cool trick. What a cool trick. All right. Excellent. All right, Mack.
Thank you.
That's good. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.